Now, I know we like to go straight to WhiteHouse.com or Wikipedia when we look up these political celebrities to learn more about them and their lives. But I thought I would get in touch with someone who was around during the area, or the era, someone who was around during the era of James Buchanan and his presidency. So I asked my Grandma Kathy about her thoughts on President James Buchanan and what this is my great grandma, but we call her Grandma Kathy.
Right.
And what life was like while she...
That's like an Italian thing, right?
Yes, while he was in office. Yeah. So I asked her to just leave me a voicemail with a couple details about just like life and society and what things were like back then and the political politics of the era.
There was probably so much of that too.
Yeah.
Politics.
She is, 102, I think.
Okay. Yeah. She'd have to be.
Yeah. So unfortunately, she mistakenly thought I was talking about a boy she went to school with named James Buchanan. So we went back and forth for a while. We were playing phone tag. Oof. She's very old. And I couldn't get her to distinguish the
She'd
two
have to be. She'd have to be.
Stories. So I just let her go on. I just listened to whatever she had to say. And
when women speak also.
Yeah. I'm not going to play the voicemails. It's completely unintelligible. I can understand her, you know? Between her accent and just her age, I don't think you would be able to really understand. So I'm just going to read some quotes from her voicemails, but I'll do my best to pepper in her accent here and there, so that it makes sense phonetically, if you will.
Yeah.
Jim was a good boy. He ended up marrying Mary Lou Swamy from Iron River. He had her mom pick her up out of school when she was 12 and he 19, and as far as I know, they had a lot of kids and did all right for themselves. Jimmy Buchanan was about 21 when he won the Mora tournament at St. Rocco's Fest. I'll never forget the time your grandpa and I went to the festival of St. Rocco and St. Anthony. So many Finns with Italian dads. The meatball subs there are heavenly. They say the recipe comes straight from St. Rocco's mother herself. Anyway, Jim comes up to a tournament, houses a meatball sandwich, plays the best round of Mora you ever seen a man play. And the Buchanan kids turned out all right too. They all got them Shell service stations off of 41 along from Munising up to Ely Township. Buchanan's on 41 has always been one of the best Shells in the world. They got the cheapest gas, best bait, and loose cans of pop of every kind. Then there's that one up in Calumet next to the Bunny Ranch. You can see them little rabbits when you pump gas, which the kids always love. Your ma, God bless her, love that place. Buchanan's on 41 there in Calumet. Listeners, my mom's still alive. I don't know who she was talking about there. It could have been anyone.
Different person.
And then she said, Jack, see if you can get up there before the tourists come up and get some of that good bait they got there. Free grandpa up at the Calumet Buchanan's. So there you have it, folks. What life was like in 1850s Calumet, Michigan, under the harsh rule of Jim Buchanan and his child bride. Happy birthday, President James Buchanan.
Very cool.